remember sitting in math class during high school and hearing students ask, "Why do we have to learn math? When will we ever use it?" Math has always been my favorite subject, but I will admit that I too questioned how we could use math outside of a classroom. It wasn't until I pursued a degree in mathematics that I fully understood how we could apply math to solve real-world problems. Now, I use math as a tool to understand biological systems. As a mathematical biologist, I aim to build a bridge to connect the seemingly separate worlds of math and biology. I specifically focus on cancer biology, as cancer is one of the leading causes of death worldwide. One promising cancer treatment has been to stimulate a patient's own immune system to better fight their cancer. This is done with drugs called immunotherapies. There are many immunotherapies available, and new ones are constantly being developed. However, certain immunotherapies only work in half of patients, and some patients have bad reactions to immunotherapies. We don't know exactly why this occurs. The human body is a complex system with many different interacting parts that are hard to identify with biological experiments alone. And that's where math comes in. Math provides an ideal framework for studying cancer by modeling the interacting components in ways that allow us to control and predict different aspects of the system. In my research, I am developing a set of equations or a mathematical model that will allow us to explore the complex cancer immune system interactions of the human body and enable us to predict the most effective immunotherapy combinations. Using my model, I can perform virtual experiments where I can study and influence the dynamics and interactions between immune cells and cancer cells. My goal is to use math to identify the key features that distinguish the ability of the immune system to eliminate cancer, and those features that allow cancer to evade the immune system and persist in the body. By understanding these differences, I will be able to predict patient responses to immunotherapies and develop new combinations of drugs, doses, and schedules that can optimize treatment response and minimize unwanted side effects. Then, I can work with an experimentalist to test my model predictions in mice. If my model predictions don't match experimental results, then we can fine-tune the model using this new data. On the other hand, when my model predictions match experimental results, then we can use my model to inform human patient treatment. Unlike cancer, math is predictable, and we can use the power of mathematics to better understand the complex biology of the human body. By sharing my research, I hope that if you were one of those students questioning why we have to learn math, you can now begin to see that we can use math in all sorts of ways, including to revolutionize cancer treatment and save millions of lives. Thank you.